Aimovig. Ajovy. And Emgality. Three amazing new migraine prevention treatment options that I call the CGRP injectables. They're transforming the lives of people living with migraine. And with three options to choose from, so many people are asking, which CGRP is right for me? On this episode of the Headache Vlog. Welcome to the Headache Vlog. I'm Dr. Alexander Krob. I'm a full-time, board-certified headache medicine doctor, and I've helped thousands of people living with headache live better. I created the Headache Vlog to provide a space for information that you can use to live better too. Before we proceed with today's episode, a few important notes. First of all, the Headache Vlog is for information and entertainment purposes only. It is not medical advice. If you need medical advice, please see your doctor. So the CGRP injectables, Aimovig, Ajovy, and Emgality are three amazing new preventive options that are really transforming the lives of people living with migraine. They are part of the most important thing that someone living with migraine can do, and that is to practice prevention. Now, prevention is not what you do when you get a migraine. Preventive things tend to be things that you do on a regular basis, whether or not you have a migraine headache. And the goals of prevention are to reduce the number of days that you experience a migraine, to make the attacks less severe, and to make them respond better to the treatments that you take when you do get a migraine. You should think about and talk to your doctor about prevention if you are having four or more days of migraine in any given month, or if you are missing work or school or leaving early two or more days a month. Prevention can take many forms, often starting with lifestyle changes, including avoiding caffeine and getting regular sleep. Prevention can also involve vitamins, herbs, and other nutritional supplements, but for many people, migraine prevention involves taking one or more preventive medications. The traditional migraine preventive medications are what I call the platform treatments, and they are propranolol, amitriptyline, divalproex or Depakote, and topiramate, also called Topamax. There's also Trokendi and other variations of topiramate. All of these medications are pills. They've been around for years. They were not really created for headache diagnoses. They were created for other problems, but used over the years and actually found to be helpful, and they've helped many people. Even Botox was created for cosmetic purposes and only accidentally found to be helpful for migraine. But what if you've tried these and you're still not getting to your goal of fewer migraines? That's where these CGRP injectables come in. These are really exciting new treatments. For the first time in the history of forever, we have migraine treatments that weren't just found accidentally. They were created with an understanding of how migraines happen in the brain. So we have these three exciting new treatments. How do you tell which one is best for you? When you're deciding about a medicine, there's really four types of decision factors. The first is effectiveness. The second one is side effects or safety. Third, we always think a little bit about cost. And fourth are various other factors. Your doctor and you will have a conversation regarding the effectiveness and side effects of the CGRP injectable medications. This will be a short conversation because, on the good side, these medications have very few side effects, which we will get into later. And on the bad side, none of these medications has been compared against any of the others, and so no one knows which medication is best for any particular person or situation. I will say that again, no one knows which one of these drugs is the best. Things like cost and various other factors are probably more personal decisions that you will make on your own. With that in mind, let's look at which of these factors the CGRP injectables have in common, and where there are differences that could be important for your decision. First, let's talk about similarities that all of these CGRP treatments have in common. To begin with, these are all injections that you do yourself. The needles involved are all small, and the injections are skin deep. Injection techniques are similar. You inject into healthy skin, which means no tattoos, stretch marks, scars, veins, or other abnormal skin. You're going to use clean hands and clean the area with an alcohol swab before injecting. Also, all of these medicines can be injected once a month. There is an exception that I'll talk about later. They all share similar injection sites, either the front of the thigh or the tummy. Some of the medicines have other injection sites that you can also use. All of these medicines have to be refrigerated. When you pick them up from the pharmacy, they should be cool to the touch. And if they aren't, start asking questions. Treat them like milk. Don't put them next to the rotisserie chicken. Keep them with the cool things. And when you get home, put them in the fridge in their original box. When you are ready to use them, take them out of the fridge and let them come to room temperature naturally for 30 minutes. Don't use hot water, a microwave, or a hairdryer. These medicines also have no interactions with any other medications. So, if you take medications for headache or other conditions, interactions should not be an issue, and you should not have to stop other treatments. This means that the CGRP injectables are very different from the platform drugs, where side effects and drug interactions were fairly common. Unfortunately, all of these medicines are very expensive. They can be $500 or $600 a month if you pay full retail price. But they all come with some form of savings program that can reduce your cost if you're commercially insured to about $5 a month or less, at least for the first year or so. All of these medicines can work really fast, often with results starting in the first month. And they all have demonstrated dramatic results in many cases. Some people are reporting 50, 75, or even 100% reduction in their migraine attacks. These medications also share similar side effects, but the overall number of side effects is actually quite few, especially compared to the platform prevention treatments. The more common side effect that they all share is what is called an injection site reaction, and this happens somewhere around 10 to 30% of the time. Most people have had some kind of injection site reaction because most of us have had a flu shot. Injection site reactions include things like feeling the needle, or getting a drop of blood or a bruise, or an itchy or sore or red lump or spot at or close to the injection site. Far less common are more serious side effects, and for the CGRP injectable drugs, there are really two. One is sort of a milder allergic reaction, like a rash, and a more severe one is angioedema, which is swelling of the lips or tongue or even of the throat. Now, I have not seen any of these more serious reactions, but they have been reported to happen. Another thing these treatments have in common is that we know nothing about their safety, either good or bad, when it comes to pregnancy or breastfeeding. So you shouldn't use them if you are pregnant or breastfeeding. And because these medicines can stay in your body for 5 months after your last dose, you should stop them 5 or 6 months before becoming pregnant. We've now talked about features that all three CGRP injectables have in common. Now let's talk about some differences. Aimovig was the first CGRP injectable treatment on the market. It is available as either a 70 or 140 milligram dose that you will take once a month. You take Aimovig using the auto injector, which most people find very easy to use and not that uncomfortable. The important thing to understand about Aimovig is that in addition to the two side effects that I mentioned that all of the CGRP injectables share, Aimovig has an additional two side effects. So all of the CGRP treatments share what are called injection site reactions and share a slight chance of an allergic reaction, which in rare cases can be severe. But for people with Aimovig, constipation can be an issue in some cases, and in some of those cases, constipation can be severe. Also, for people taking the 140 milligram dose, some people have reported muscle cramps. It's also important for people who are allergic to latex to understand that this part of the injector, this part right here, it does contain natural latex rubber, and that could be a deciding point for some of you. In addition to the active ingredient in the Aimovig injection, there are also some additives, including acetate, polysorbate, and sucrose. Aimovig can be left at room temperature for up to 7 days, but if you don't use it within that 7-day period, you have to throw it away and start with a fresh refrigerated dose. Like I said, Aimovig retails at about $500 to $600 a month, but with the Aimovig savings card, you can reduce that cost to about $5 per dose, and that's good for 12 doses. The second CGRP injectable to hit the market is Ajovy. And Ajovy is different from the others in several ways. First, Ajovy comes as an injection of 225 milligrams that you can take every month, or you can take three injections on the same day every 3 months. Ajovy currently comes as what's called a pre-filled syringe that looks a lot like this demonstrator unit here. In addition to the two side effects that all CGRP drugs share, and remember that's injection site reaction and allergic reaction, Ajovy has no additional recognized side effects. Additives in the Ajovy include EDTA, histamine, and polysorbate. You can keep Ajovy at room temperature for up to 24 hours, but if you don't use it within that time, you have to discard it and start again with a refrigerated dose. Once you activate your Ajovy savings card, you can get your Ajovy treatments for $5 a month. The third CGRP injectable treatment to hit the market is Emgality. And Emgality is different from the others in the following ways. It's available as either a pre-filled syringe or as this auto-injector, and each dose has 120 milligrams. The auto-injector looks like this, and when you do your first treatment with Emgality, you're going to give yourself two injections. After that, it's one injection a month. Like Ajovy, there are no additional side effects of Emgality other than the two that I've mentioned, which are injection site reaction and the chance of an allergic reaction. Additives in the injection include histidine and polysorbate. You can leave this at room temperature for up to 7 days before you use it, but if you don't use it within that time, you have to discard it and start again with a fresh refrigerated dose. The current Emgality savings card lets you have a dose for $0. So I hope you have enjoyed this episode on which CGRP is right for me. If you need more information, please talk with your doctor. You can also go to aimovig.com, ajovy.com, or emgality.com for the most up-to-date information on each of the medications that we talked about today. If you liked this episode, please give me a thumbs up. And if you want up-to-date information on how to live better when you're living with headaches, please hit the subscribe button and don't forget to ring the bell for reminders when new episodes are posted. Thank you very much for watching. I'm Dr. Alexander Krob, and this has been the Headache Vlog.